the EESC, the European Commission, the European Parliament, and especially various trade unions have all engaged in discussions, brought up reports and studies on employee financial participation and employee share ownership. The results of these recommendations were all the same. Employee financial participation schemes can offer direct financial benefits. Sharing in ownership offers employees the right to enjoy the benefits of the company's success, or whilst also participating in the responsibility and risks attached to the strategic decisions. Sharing profits can reward success and supplement workers' incomes, which further boosts their overall spending power in the economy. These benefits were emphasized during a resolution by the European Parliament in 2014. We called upon the European Commission to assess potential policy initiatives aimed at reducing the barriers to cross-border employee financial participation schemes and to provide more information on the issue, as many employees and employers, in particular SMEs, currently lack access to information on employee financial participation schemes. Less than one-third of companies in the European Union offers financial participation for their employees. The gap between workers and those with wealth continues to grow, as the current trend in most of the OECD countries shows. Employee financial participation can help to bridge the gap. But financial participation is not only about the economic advantage, it goes ways further, and that's important. It's also about mutual respect and appreciation, about identification between companies and employees. And it also serves a sustainable and long-term orientation of the company. For a EU-wide spread of these models, we need to have a stronger exchange on best practices. Those best practices are, for instance, sociedades laborales in Spain, or what I know best, the Employee Share Participation Foundation of First Alpine AG in Austria. It's the only model with international voting rights, bundling while having individual shareholding, and that's it. Voting rights, information, consultation. Employees are entitled to a fair share of a company's success, and the income must represent a fair share of the national income of the company. The current trend in most of the OECD countries shows that income inequality has strongly increased. So we're moving to the worst direction. Spain, Portugal, Ireland, Greece, and Italy are at the top of the list with the highest level of inequality, while Finland, the Netherlands, and Austria show much less inequality according to the Gini ranking. So from January 2016, income tax exemption on employee shares plans increased from 1,400 around to 3,000 euro per year in Austria. And to conclude, what's so important about all that? To have this fair share, so voting rights, whatever you do in these schemes are so important. And of course, always keep also a little bit the dangers in mind. We see, for example, at McDonald's, that somehow when you have enterprises that shift with systems their profits away, that there is not so much left also in the schemes for the workers. So be aware of the advantages, but be aware also of those false promises sometimes big enterprises give. So thanks for listening, and have a very good debate. Bye.